Hi, this is Carla with Legacy Marketing, and today I'm going to show you how to set up your LinkedIn account so that every time you post something new to your blog or your website, it will show up on your LinkedIn profile and let your LinkedIn contacts get your latest updates. So this is a profile, actually a new profile for a client of mine. They just signed up for LinkedIn, so they don't have a whole lot of information there. And what we need to do is when you edit your profile, you're going to go to websites and add a website. And then you have some options. You can do personal website, company, blog, RSS feed, portfolio, other. I'm going to put blog for this, and then I'm going to put in her domain name. And then we're just going to click Save Changes. The one thing is that you can have several different sites. Actually, it has an option for three. One thing that you want to keep in mind is that what I'm going to show you, what happens is if you have a website that automatically has an RSS feed set up to be auto-discovered by like feed readers, anything that you list here under blog or company website or RSS feed or portfolio, if it has an RSS feed that is auto-discovered, then those posts will show up on your profile. For example, I had one of my clients that wanted to add the URL to where they posted articles on a separate site, and she had listed her URL it was actually her author profile page. The problem was that I don't even remember what site it was now, but that article directory or that website didn't have individual RSS feeds for each author. So what happened was when she put that URL on her LinkedIn profile, it wasn't showing just her articles. It was showing every single article that was published on the site. So you just have to be careful about that. And just if you're going to do what I show you, just remember that you have to only list something that has an RSS feed that you want to show. So once we have that saved, we're going to go to more, and then we need to go to get more applications. What we want is blog link by Six Park. Just click on that. You have two options. You can select to display it on your profile, which we definitely want, and then display on the LinkedIn homepage. So this is just giving them permission that if they think that your article or blog post is newsworthy, that it could be included in consideration for that homepage. So we're just going to click an added application and then click on by me. And this shows the most recent post that she's made. Now going to her website, one of the ways you can tell if an RSS feed is available or is auto-discovered on a site is in Internet Explorer. There's a little icon. I think this is Internet Explorer 8 or 9, I don't remember, but in this little icon, if this is highlighted then and showing is orange, then that means that there is an RSS feed. So this is what the RSS feed looks like. Now going back to when you're setting up your LinkedIn profile, you want to make sure that you are aware of the URLs that you're entering and make sure that you know what's going to be showing up, because it could look a little odd. So before you add anything on that on your profile, you know, just make sure that whatever URL you're entering, that it's showing what you think it's going to show. Going back to your profile, let's go back and look at her main site now. She has a link here for her blog. She had a different company link that would show up. So going down on her profile, it's showing the most recent blog post. And if she had multiple websites that had an RSS feed listed set to display, then it would show up, you know, the most recent first, depending on the site. And that's all there is to it. It's basically just a two-step process. You add the website to your LinkedIn profile, and then you add the blog link application to that profile. And now this is one of the steps that I include in my free report called 10 Steps to Success with WordPress. It's how to get more exposure for content on your site. So if you don't already have that report, you can go to my website and sign up for my newsletter and download that. And I cover three other really basic steps to getting your information out there and automating the process of distributing your content. Now, if you're wondering if this is worth it, for myself and my business is primarily business to business. So I have contacts on LinkedIn, I have a Facebook page, I have, you know, a pretty decent Twitter following. But when I publish a new post, all of my blog posts are automatically published to each of those social media accounts. And for me in my business, I actually get more click-throughs and more viewers to my site from my LinkedIn profile, even though I don't have as many people as I do on some of my other accounts. I think it's that it's more targeted for what I'm doing, and the people that are my LinkedIn contacts just tend to be more interested in what I'm writing for my business posts. So that's just one thing to consider. So when you are writing something on your website or your blog, you want to get as much bang for your buck as possible. You want to get as most return on your efforts as you possibly can. And part of that is getting your content and information out there in front of as many eyes as possible. And this is just one way to make it easy, and you set it up once, then you don't even have to worry about it again. So I hope this is helpful to you, and please feel free to leave any comments if you have any other questions. Thanks again.